Friends, welcome back to Get Your Play Online. My name is Emily B, and today we're gonna be doodling some things for fun. So since it's sports week, I decided to learn how to draw a few sports related items. So today we're going to learn how to draw a baseball. A baseball bat, a basketball, a basketball hoop, and lastly, a surfboard. Where are we? We're over here. And then we're gonna kind of have fun today coloring and just chatting about sports. And if there is some time in the end and you want to see something that I haven't drawn, maybe something about your favorite sport or just something you want to learn how to draw that's sports related, you can put it in the comments and I will draw it for you. So let's get started. So first, let's see, we're gonna do the baseball. So the baseball, let me actually move my camera here for you so you guys can see when I draw down. So bear with me for a second. Give me 1 second while we move everything. Let's see. Think you're able to see that? Perfect. So, for the baseball today, we're gonna need a black marker and a red marker. But, and kind of as I go along with these pictures, I'm gonna show you what colors I use, but it doesn't matter. You guys can use whichever colors you like. This time is about being creative and just having fun. So, for the first step of the baseball, we're just gonna draw a circle. So there's my circle. It doesn't have to be perfect, just, you know, any type of circle. Secondly, so I don't know if you see on the baseball, see how it has these lines here? So we're just going to draw some lines. And for this line, we're going to start here at the top, and we're going to go out and back in and connect to the bottom. So it's kind of half a circle or a curvy line here, with the curve going in. So again, start from the top, go out, then in. Now, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we're gonna start here at the top, go out, then in, like that. And I'll do it again just in case. Out, and then in. Start at the top and end at the bottom. Perfect. And step three now is we're going to draw little upside down V's. So do we all know what a V looks like? So I'll draw. So a V is like that. That's a V here. But today we're gonna draw upside down V's. So an upside down V would just start from the outside, go up, and then down. Just like that. So on the baseball, let me see if I can we're gonna go just starting at the top, and they're gonna be little V's. So up, down, just like that. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. And the middle of the V, this middle is going to be on top of the line that we created here. So let's try and do the same thing on the other side. So we start here, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And there you go. Now you can do it. I did black and red, but you can do any color that you like. So I'm just gonna go along the outside again with the black marker. And just make it a little more darker. And there you go. That is a baseball. Oop, let me see if I can. And like I said, it doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be red and black and be whatever colors you want. So now, to go with the baseball, what else? What has to go with the baseball? I think a baseball bat goes with a baseball. So then we can hit the baseball. So for that, let's see. Go move the camera again. So for that, let's see what a baseball bat looks like. So this was what I drew earlier for the bat, and it's just, there we are, a baseball bat. So for that, I'll draw it right next to our baseball. So for that, we're gonna need a brown marker and or a crayon, and again the red. But like I said before, you guys can do whatever you want. So for this, we're gonna first draw a line at the top. You see that there? And then, once we draw our line, just one line, we're gonna go down. And when we go down, it's not gonna be a completely straight line like that. It's gonna be a little bit slanting towards the inside. So we're gonna go, here's our line, down, a little bit sloping, and then we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So here, we're gonna go down and sloping towards this middle. Got it? So we can do it again just to so you guys can see. Let me see if I can move this a little better for you. Oh. Here we are. So first our line, and then down here and down here. Then, we're gonna make the lines a little longer and meet them at the bottom. And when we meet them at the bottom, we'll meet them at a line here. Like I said, it's not perfect, but we'll get the hang of it. And then once we do that, we're just gonna draw a little line, a little circle here at the bottom. And that is gonna be the handle. So a little circle here. And then next, we're gonna color it in. So one line here, and one line here. And then we can color the rest of the top brown. So So color, color, color. Or whatever color you decided to do your baseball bat. There we are. And then for the three stripes at the bottom that we did here, I want to do red. So one stripe, two stripe, three stripe. Oh, and we can't forget the color of the handle. Ta-da! So like I said, it's not perfect, but it's okay. This is just for fun, and it doesn't always have to be perfect. So look, now we have our baseball bat hitting our baseball. I wonder how far it'll go, huh? Great, so now we did that, so I'll put it right here. Oops. So now, let's draw our basketball. So let's look at what our basketball looked like before. So here's a basketball I made earlier. So look, mine is orange and black, but again, your basketball can be whatever color you want. It could be your favorite color. So for this, we'll need, well, let's close the caps on our red and our brown from our baseball. So for the basketball, we're gonna need a black marker and an orange marker. So let's see if this works for everybody. So first, what we do with our black marker is we're going to draw a circle. And like with the baseball, it definitely doesn't have to be perfect. I'm seeing if everyone can see this. It doesn't have to be perfect. Mine's definitely not perfect, but that's okay. So first we draw a circle. And does everyone know how to draw a circle? We can draw a few on the side just in case. So with a circle, we're just gonna go round until we meet our first line. We could do it again here. Round until we meet our first line there. Okay, so here is our basketball circle. So with a basketball, it can be a little bit tricky with the lines. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna start in the middle. And then we're gonna create one line slanting downwards. So we're gonna start here, go straight, and we're gonna slant it a little bit downwards like that. So it's not completely straight, but it slants a little bit to down. Next, we're gonna create, it's gonna look like a moon on the side here. So on the opposite side from where we started our line here, we're gonna go and create like a crescent moon, like a half moon on the side here. So then it also connects with our first line there. So we can recap what we've done so far. So we've done a circle, and then we did our slanting line in the middle, and then we created our moon on the side. Next, we're gonna create, we're gonna create a line, a squiggly line now. So we're gonna start here, we're gonna go down and up. So we're going to start down, and then we're going to start going up where this line is. So down, up, down, up. Now we're going to do the same thing on the bottom, but on the opposite side. So now we're going to go up, down. Just like that. Up, down, just like that. So the first one on the top was down, up, and now we're gonna go up, down. And there you go. That is the outline of our basketball. So now we can color it in however we want. So I'm gonna color it in like how I see a lot of basketballs, which is orange. So with this, we're just gonna color all in all the lines like that. I find that coloring helps me relax a little, and it's really fun. Do you like coloring? And if so, what is your favorite thing to color? I think for me, my favorite thing to color is flowers. I love to color flowers and plants and trees and things you see outside. But the good thing about this is that we get to learn how to color a lot of different things. Okay, so now I finished coloring in my basketball. What do you guys think? I like it. So now with our basketball, what do you throw a basketball in? Do you throw it in the garbage can? No. You throw it in a basketball hoop. So that's what we're gonna draw now. So first I'm gonna try and put the camera somewhere where it's not moving a lot, because I realize I am moving the camera a lot. So hopefully that'll be okay for you. Okay. So, and remember, we gotta put the caps back on from our basketball drawing. So for the hoop, let's see where my hoop was. So this is the hoop I drew earlier. So, for this, we're going to need two different types of markers. We're going to need a black one and whatever color you want the net to be. So, I'm going to do a green net because I like the color green, but you can do whatever color you want. So, for the basketball hoop, so we can actually draw the basketball hoop here. So, it's like the basketball is going into the hoop. So to start off, we're going to draw the backboard of the basketball hoop, which is these little squares here. And that, on a real basketball hoop, is just so when you throw the basketball, it has a hard surface to bounce off so it can go in the hoop. So for that, we're going to draw two squares. So our first square. Be right here. There is our first square. And then our second square is going to be on the inside. Just like that. And for squares, we go one line here, we go to the side, then we go a line up, then the other side and line down. So remember, to one side here, line up, the other side, and then line down. Good job. Now, we're going to draw the hoop bit. So, for the hoop part, the net that the ball goes in, we're going to draw first a circle. But not a wide circle, more like an oval, actually, that has the line, the bottom line from the big square going through it, just like that. So we can go one here and around like that. And an oval is different from a circle because an oval is taller, whereas a circle is the same amount of height and the same amount of thickness on each side. An oval is taller than it is wide. Or, I guess in this case, shorter than it is wide. Okay, so now that we've gotten this, we're going to go from one end of the oval. We're going to draw a line slanting down like that to the center, like we did for our baseball bat. So we did that on one side, just one line, and we're going to do that again, slanting down towards the middle on our other side. And then we're going to put a line connecting those two lines. So again, our oval, and then one line down here, one line going down this way, and then connect them in the middle. And now, to create this kind of netting here, we're gonna go one line down this way, one line down this way, and one line down this way. We're gonna create some crisscrosses. So once we have our lines going down, we're gonna create lines going to the side. So one line here, one line here, one line there. Just like that. And just like that, we have our crisscrosses to make our basketball net. And the final touch to our basketball net is we gotta make it stand up somehow. It can't just float in the air, as cool as that would be. So to make it stand up, I'm gonna create a line coming down from the basket. So it looks like that it's coming from this backboard. And then we're gonna create a line going from the side to side where our line going down meets it. And then we can create a rectangle here. So a rectangle is either taller or wider than it is wide or tall, if that makes sense. So a square, all of our sides are the same length, but with a rectangle, two of our sides are longer than the other sides. There we have it. This is our basketball net. So let's look at our picture, what we have here. Let's see, here we go. We have our basketball, and it's doo-doo-doo-doo-doo going into our net. And we have a goal. Super cool, huh? Awesome. All right, so next, now that we have our basketball, I'm going to put it where I put our other drawings. We're going to create, and this is our last picture for today, but it's going to be a fun one, I promise. A surfboard. So a lot of the times we hear about sports like basketball and baseball. But surfing is also a sport. And here we are. So surfing is like, we have a surfboard in the water and you balance on the surfboard and you ride on all the waves in the water. So for our surfboard, our colors that we're gonna use, the good thing about this is we can use whatever colors we want. So I'm gonna use some of my favorite colors, which I have pink, I have green, and then I'm gonna have this kind of light pink color here, and we're gonna use some blue for the water. That's just for the surfboard. So it's four colors in total, but you can use as many or as little colors as you wish. So for this, we get our first color, so mine is pink. We're gonna create, remember our upside down V from our baseball? So we're gonna do something similar to this, except our V is gonna be curved, so these lines aren't gonna be straight. So, and we're kind of, we can also start, we're going to do them, instead of upside down, we're going to do them sideways. So, remember what a V looks like? Here's a V, right? We're going to draw our V like that. There you go. So our surfboard, we're going to start at one point, and we're going to go curvy V all the way like this, and curvy V all the way like that. Again, curvy V like this, and then curvy V on the top. And then we're going to connect these two lines here, like that. And that is our whole entire surfboard, just our outline of our surfboard. And now this is where it gets fun, because we can draw whatever we want on our surfboard. So I'm going to color in my surfboard with pink first. And then I'm going to put some flowers on top, because remember I said my favorite thing to draw were flowers. So let's color in our surfboard. Right there. And then with the green, I'm going to make flowers. So, some petals here. And for flowers, for the flowers I'm drawing, we just draw a point in the middle, and then we go almost a circle there, a circle on the top, a circle on the bottom, and a circle on the side. And it looks like a flower. And then we can color them in too, so they're a little bit darker on our background of our surfboard. We can draw the flower again. So remember, a circle here, a circle on one side, the other, top and bottom. And then I'm going to draw one more here. So again, our point in the middle, oval circle here, circle here, circle on the bottom, and circle on the side. And then we color them in. So this is what my surfboard looks like so far. So we can recap how we drew it. So remember, we did our upside down, our curvy V. So curvy V here, curvy V that way. And then we took a line and connected these two here. And then we colored in our surfboard. What color is your surfboard? Is it pink like mine? Or maybe it's green or blue or yellow or red? There's so many options. So then we colored in and we created a design. So I did flowers on mine, but you can do like fire flames, or we can do happy faces, or whatever you want on your surfboard. So now a surfboard is used in the water, right? So we can't really surf on land. We're going to surf in the water. So we can draw some water all around our surfboard. Like in the ocean, or you can surf in a lake, I guess. Maybe if there's waves. So more like you surf in the ocean. So let's draw some waves, right, for our ocean. There we are. So that's my ocean right here. So now, to make this picture complete, you can draw yourself surfing on the surfboard. So I'm going to draw myself. So here's my head. So it's a circle, hopefully. Here's a circle. And then I don't know if you can see it right now, but my hair is curly and brown. It's up right now. So I'm going to draw my curly hair on my head. So here I have my brown marker, and we're going to draw curly, curly, curly like that. And all it is loop, go around, loop that again, like that. And then I have my eyes. My eyes are brown, like my hair. And then I'm going to create a smiley face, because if I was surfing, I think I'd be smiling. Like that. Then I'm gonna draw my neck and my bathing suit. So like I said, my favorite color is pink, so I'm gonna stick with pink. To draw my bathing suit, I'm gonna draw the neck here, and then like we're gonna go out like that, down, and going back like that. So almost like a square without this without the last line here. So a three-sided square. So out, down, and in. So those are where my arms are gonna be. So let's put my arms here. Woo! Surfing in the USA. That's gonna be so much fun. And then we're gonna draw my body. And then my shorts, my swim shorts. So we're gonna go like that for my shorts. So it's kind of the same thing as the sleeves. So we're gonna go down to the side and up, down to the side and up. And we're gonna meet here in the middle. And then my legs. So here's a line for my legs and my feet right here. It's not very, it's a stick figure drawing, but that's okay. And here, I'm having so much fun. I'm drawing my hands. So for that, I'm just drawing five lines because I have five fingers. Just like that. So I'm excited to see what you look like on your surfboard. Ooh, and lastly, I'm going to color in my swim costume to match my surfboard. So mine is pink. What color is yours? And there we go. That is our surfing picture. I'm excited to see how yours turned out. I'm sure if you tag get your play online, we can see all of your cool pictures. So let's recap on what we do today. So first, we drew a baseball. We learned how to draw a baseball and a bat to hit our baseball. Second, we learned how to draw a basketball, and then the basketball hoop that it goes inside of so we can score all of the goals. And then lastly, we learned how to draw a surfboard, and we could create a picture of ourselves on our surfboard, or of your brother or your sister or whoever you want to draw on the surfboard. And we have our water here. Move this back up. There we are. So I had so much fun drawing with you today. I think I'm gonna hang these pictures up, and I'm sure you can hang your pictures up on your wall. And like I said, if you tag us and you put your pictures online, we can see them all, and I can see all of the pretty drawings that you drew. Thank you guys so much. I had so much fun, and I hope you have a wonderful day and continue watching all of the activities we have planned for you. Bye!